things which they are speaking against you as evildoers, they may, as a result of your fine works, of which
it is sacred service, rendered by
the world is created. Well, the answer is obvious, isn't it? We are drawn to those appealing qualities of Jehovah God. But perhaps more importantly, who are we imitating? Just consider that area of speaking the truth. Now we're aware, aren't we, that Jehovah desires all of us to speak the truth, to be truthful in our dealings. That's why we take to people the good news of truth, don't we, in our ministry. But do we imitate the God of truth when it comes to our daily speech, maybe with our family, with our spiritual family, our brothers and sisters in the congregation? Now that can at times be a little more challenging. Why do we say that? Sometimes we've done or said something that's unkind. Now how do you feel when someone confronts you about that matter?
Blessed be Jehovah God, Israel's God. That is Israel's God, who alone is doing wonderful works. And you could liken it to the kind of musical episode called a crescendo. We're going to prove that is not the case. Now first, would you go to Psalm 19, which you remember we looked at as the first scripture yesterday.